The beginning of the sequence features a title sequence where Groot is dancing in the foreground, and it doesn't cut. So it is on Groot the whole time. He's got to hold the attention of the viewers with his crazy little dance, whilst what happens in the background never stops. So we've got something like 4,000 frames of continuous action. We were faced with the fact that the environment was completely spectacular and had to be created entirely digitally. Everything that we were inserting had to be reflected, and that's multiple times the computation to compute the light for what's landing on them, but also their reflection. And so everything ended up being done two or three times because of the surface of the world they were standing on. We were delighted to have the opportunity to take on Rocket the Raccoon. The fur shaders that we've got here at Framestore, the muscle systems, all of these things had updated in the 3 years between the first Guardians and this one. So we wanted to bring all of that into Rocket, which meant rebuilding him from the ground up, and yet making sure that he was absolutely recognizable as the same character from the first movie. Space being very open, it's very hard to tell how fast things are moving, and James Gunn's very keen on selling the speed of the action. So we conceived of these sort of wafts and waves of plasma energy that lived in and around this planet, which we could whip past the camera to really sell how fast the camera and the spaceships were all moving. James Gunn is all about the fantastic. It doesn't really matter how outlandish what is outside the window is. If it looks crazy and like something else, something that nobody's seen before, that is pretty much what the Doctor ordered. So there's a scene in the middle of the movie where Rocket and Yondu are in prison, but then when they break out, they're on board this enormous great big spaceship, which of course didn't exist. We had big shots of Yondu walking through these huge hallways full of spaceships and sort of docking bay, with all of the Ravagers, who are the crew of the spaceship, being shot at with his arrow. Ultimately, the arrow which Yondu is firing works its way all around the spaceship, so we had to pretty much design the interior of the spaceship to give a really satisfying journey for this arrow to take, and it looks like a Busby Berkeley movie, like with crazy camera angles. Every movie that we get involved in, we want to be, you know, pushing the envelope, trying something new, with, you know, expectation that we're going to get there.